Now, you might remember a couple of years ago, the AU went through a dramatic round of cost-cutting measures that included the players taking pay cuts. Now, this was interesting at the time because the players were actually copying a fair bit of grief about being overpaid and suggestions coming back that they shouldn't be paid at all for a loss. Now, I spoke with Rupa, Chief Executive Ross Zenos, last week, and he revealed to me that the players actually agreed to take those pay cuts, and in the end, those same pay cuts are keeping the Melbourne Rebels afloat.
Very interesting, because you are right. At the time, I remember the players were getting criticised for being overpaid, and then it wasn't really properly explained why these pay cuts were organised. And, you know, at the moment, they probably didn't get the credit they deserve. And if it's come out that part of it was to say the Melbourne Rebels were good on the players, because even though I've been critical of the five-team structure, I do understand the importance of having some sort of identity of rugby in Melbourne. So, but now the point is, good on the players, but it really needs the Melbourne Rebels to really pick up their act and make certain they get private ownership going and be self-sufficient, because if they keep bleeding from the AU, it's going to cause major problems, as we discovered this year. But you might be able to give us a bit more of how the players actually help the Rebels go there.
Yeah, well, it's big of them, and I think it's going to paint them in a pretty favourable light, Greg, you know, because after that Lions series, they were down, they were out, they forewent, I think, between about $4 and $5.5 million of money that they could have taken from that Lions tour, and then, of course, they reduced their match payments from $13,000 down to $10,000, which is a pretty significant step. I mean, it's good money, yes, but at the same time, that adds up to about, I think it was between $1 and $1.5 million in match payments over the next couple of years as well. Mm. So it's big of the players, and certainly, you know, at a time when Australia and rugby was pretty rocky, it wasn't made public, but being able to bring that out now and heading into a World Cup just builds a little bit of favour.
Well, yes, and also it will help, because I know there's suggestions there's going to be some pretty lucrative World Cup bonuses for the players, and sometimes in the past when that's come out, it's caused criticism the players are overpaid. But yes, they have done the right thing the last few years. They've shrunk their income, and that's tough, because you've got to understand with footballers, and we've talked about this many times before, their lifespan in football is not that long. So, and for a lot of them, the period where they're playing between 18 and 30 is when a lot of other people are establishing themselves in businesses. So when they finish playing football, they are right on the back foot trying to get jobs. So you can understand them trying to get as much money as they can. So you are correct. The players should probably have deserved more credit for what they did. But now it's for the Melbourne Rebels and to really say, we'll get our act together and get sorted out. But also, the point is, you've got to remember in the past, the Waratahs have struggled. They had to be saved by the ARU about a decade ago. The Queensland Reds were enormous strife many years ago, and that's sort of been forgotten, that everything's great. And the Brumbies have always struggled as well, but good management of the Brumbies has kept them afloat. So the Rebels is not an isolated incident, but still, the pressure is on the province to really make itself.
And the big thing with this is also that long-awaited broadcast deal. I mean, we keep hearing this narrative coming out of the AU and Sansa. It's going to be great. It's going to be gold. It's going to really help rugby in Australia, but we're still waiting.
I know. I was told it was supposed to be last October. I just wonder whether the latest stop might be because of what the AU done with the overseas eligibility, and whether the Fox and these guys are thinking, this could affect the standard of Super Rugby, and whether that stopped it. But you are right. There are so many unknown questions at the moment, because we're waiting for the Sansar deal. And as it is in American dollars, it does depend on what day it is with the Australian dollar sinking. So it's, but still, we get getting told that it's going to be a very, very good deal for Australian rugby. But you can't really say it is until we see it. So hopefully within the next 4 or 5 years, we find out what actually the broadcasting deal is.
Big props to the Wallabies players. Regardless, their foregone sacrifices are keeping the Rebels afloat.